Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Coldborough Park Farm, where it's time. Well, I say that right now. I'm gonna do something I should have probably done. There we go. It is time. Now that the night has miraculously just ended, it's time to get rid of the Massey. Actually, I can't get rid of it quite yet. I've just realised. I don't want to be given to the shop like this. I mean, it's probably going to be sitting around in there for a while, because it does have an unusual design. My people like the droop nose. So, I'm going to make the most of it for them. And what I'm going to do is, I am going to bring it over here and just shut it off. Hopefully I can get the spray over this far. I can, lovely. What we're going to do is we're going to give it a good wash. Get all the mud and dirt off it, because it has been in the fields for a while. It's done its fair share of work. It's got a few hundred hours on the clock, so it's about time this thing goes away. Looks nice and clean. While we're at this, we might as well get the harvester cleaned off as well. Just while we got the power washer in use. That looks like it's clean now. The header at least, let's get the harvest cleaned up. I'll bring it back into the shed at some point later on today. I don't think you guys quite need to see that. Walk across the top of the header as you do. There we go, all nice and clean. And ready to go back into storage for, well, the winter and spring, I guess. Hopefully we'll be getting out in the early summer again. Quite a late harvest this year though, so hopefully we'll be getting some seed into the ground fairly soon and dealing with things from there. So it's off down to the shop we go. Let's turn on the beacons. I have made some purchases, you might have spotted. There have been some purchases made. I need to check some stuff, hopefully. Hopefully what I've got planned isn't really stupid. Because we're going to be swapping this Massey for a slightly bigger model. We've got a part exchange arranged. Luckily the shop opens up at, well, the dealership opens up at about 7 every morning to deal with my inane demands, so. I mean, they've had 15 minutes to open up shop and all that kind of stuff, so hopefully they're not too angry at me for showing up at 7:15 on a whatever day this is morning. And of course the idiots driving at 30 kilometers an hour are back, because of course they are. I did see some changes that I need to make over the winter while I was working on the small bales. They're all sold off now, by the way. All the small, all but one, because I found one in one of the fields when I was starting to clear out the rest of them. I have a new baler. I'll be showing that off to you guys before the end of the video. I know that much. I don't know when exactly. But what I did earlier on today, just out of character, it was earlier on today. This is, it's Sunday, it's, what, 4 minutes past nine, so it's quite a significant amount of time after the stream. The game has literally been paused for that entire time, because not long after the stream ended, my sister came home, and then my parents came home, and then all kinds of things happened. So let's sell this for 70,200. We've got 170,000 euro to play with. And again, out of character for those of you who missed the stream on Sunday, yesterday I guess, we're playing this in a, I've decided this is a kind of an alternate reality where Britain has the euro for some reason. So let's have a look at what we can buy. We can get the 66-16, just a bit short on the 77. What does our 60-40 have? 160. So I want to be going over 160 in terms of horsepower. I don't want to get this 77 for reasons. That's 135. I want to be going over 160. I was kind of hoping of getting the 77. Let's... Can I take any more of a loan? By any chance? Yes. Let's actually borrow some money here. So let's take out the full loan that we can. And head over to these new Hollands. I can now get the 66-16 or this. You know, the 77 is probably the... 77-18 is probably a better idea. Can't quite afford the 26, so the 77-18. I may need to get a second tractor. I've just spotted something with that that might not be what I need. I may have caused myself trouble. Oh nuts. I have. That's gonna be problematic. So what I wanted was a tractor that was powerful and reasonably large, but also had a front loader. I fulfilled two of those three criteria because this thing doesn't have a front loader mount. Can I get a like cheapo tractor for less than 40,000, maybe? Get the JXU85, that I know has a front loader mount. I guess we're getting the JXU, because the cheapest new Holland is 54,000, yeah. So we're also gonna buy a JXU85. It's a small tractor, I'll be using it as a yard tractor as well as the front loader, so it will have more than one use. This thing needs to have its beacons on, seeing as I'm on the roads. I'm not towing anything, but it is just good practice. So I'll head back up to the farm now, and this is actually going to go onto the baler immediately, because this has got 18 horsepower over the New Holland in theory. I don't know what it's got in practice. So, a bit of information about the baler we bought. Because it was brought in just before the shop closed, and unfortunately came in when I didn't have the video camera running. It is available on one of the streams. They delivered it really late, actually. It was like almost midnight when it was brought in. It is a Class Quadrant 1200. It's a really nice baler. It's second hand. It's, for some reason, they reset the bale counter on me, but they said it had like 20 or 30,000 bales. Probably, I think they missed a zero, to be quite honest. But I mean, it's not a bad baler. It doesn't agree with the New Holland, unfortunately. It's kind of run up against a power issue, in that the baler's a bit heavier than I thought, and I forgot the baler's had weight, so the New Holland isn't able to pull the baler, which is a shame. One thing the shop has got in recently, and I probably won't be buying it anytime soon now that I'm down to $2,000 again. Well, I've still got the stock of wheat, barley, and canola to sell off, so we may be in luck. As you can see from all of my overlays, which are awesome, we have 16,000 litres of seeds available. We actually filled up the seed master not too long ago with some barley, which hopefully isn't all miraculous left of becoming seeds. Okay, so it has. That's a thing that happened. I think something might be broken. So the baler should be over here somewhere. I think I left it up in this field over here. Or did I leave it in there? I'm just going to consult with my maps, because I marked down where I left it. It is down over by field 8, apparently. Which is fine. I guess I misremembered. Oh yeah, I put it into the little lay-by over here, didn't I? Did I? Where did I put the baler? It says it's down here. Ah, there it is. I put it at the entrance of the field for some reason. So let's get it hooked up. Actually, I need to reverse a small bit more. And that should do it. And attach the PTO. Should be a canola field here, maybe. Oh no, this was a wheat field as well. I'm gonna bring it. Screw it, I'm gonna bale this field up. So, with the small bales all sorted out, the baler doesn't sound too healthy, but I'm assured that it is. I've made a few bales with it, but it suddenly doesn't sound as healthy as it did. What we're doing is just picking up what the small baler missed, and all of our baling equipment will be kept. This is our baler. The bale trailer is a Marshall, I think it's a 32 foot trailer. The bale forks are Stall branded, as is the front loader mount itself. So I mean, I've got some decent quality stuff. It's just I didn't have the power in the track in the Massey to pull it, or to pull, or to, well, I did have the power in the Massey to pull it. Well, the trailer at least. The New Holland didn't enjoy the baler, especially uphill. This thing seems to get along with it a bit better. There's definitely less disagreement going on. Am I picking up everything nicely? Yes. Lovely. Let's just ease around this corner. I may have to come back to pick up some loose straw over there. But this is just to ensure. All this baling is just to ensure that we are getting all of the money we possibly can out of these fields. That's the long and the short of it. Is I don't want to be gypped by me missing stuff with the baler, so I've gone and splurged for next year's baler now. I mean, I know it's not new, I know it's not the latest, greatest model, but It is a functional baler. It creates decent bales. I think you said the density was 2,500 litres of bale. Which, you know, isn't bad. It's got 125 horsepower requirements, so we're pulling the tractor and the baler and the bales that are in it. With, what was it, 53 horsepower, which... This is definitely a few tons of equipment here, so... I mean, I don't expect it to... I don't expect to be getting max speed out of this. Looks like we're going to be dropping a bale soon, though. Oh, we have dropped one already. Somewhere. But, yeah, they're nice bales. Nice size of baler. It's not the newest, so... I mean, it's not going to give us 4,000 litre bales like the Corona would. But... Really, I don't need, you know, 4,000 litre nice, tight, dense bales. I want bales that function as bales. I want bales that I can use and move about. I mean, I'm just selling them right now, so there's no need to get the latest, greatest baler. See if I can actually pick up this section of straw from this direction. I might have to turn the baler around entirely to do this. Oh no, I can. It appears I've accidentally, on purpose, somewhat reversed out the gate. Okay, so that's that all picked up. Let's just turn the baler off temporarily. Yes, well done me. For a moment, and raise the pickup, just shoot down the field, and we're going to ignore all that because that's third and fourth lane stuff, because this is the lane we're interested in. So this Quadrant 1200, it is a few years old. I mean, I'm not too bothered by the age. We are only just getting into bales. I think the for the equipment that we currently have, or we had at the time, the big pack was a bit too much. As much as it pains me to say it, the big pack was too much for the equipment we had. The Quadrant is a lot closer to what I think we probably should have, for this size of a farm and this size of equipment. I mean, we've got two good strong tractors now, so we shouldn't need another one for a while. And I know people were complaining about the drop nose on the 50 series, 5 series Massey. It's gone now, so rejoice. Try and pick up this bit here, as well as this is a bit of a dodgy turn I'm gonna have to do. Can I grab it? Yes. Can I hook into the windrow? No. At least not fully. I didn't quite get all of it. Let's just reverse back. And the baler is holding us back slightly, is it? Is it the rear wheels are spinning up? Can't quite see. No, they're rolling quite nicely. It's just struggling to find the torque to pull us up the hill. That's completely fine. I mean, we don't need to be going a million miles an hour with this thing. 5 miles an hour is going to be enough when we're baling full tilt. This is just cleaning up the dregs Obviously, there's not much left. With that, with the Lexion, after going over this once again, I mean, we're gonna have plenty to work through. I just hope that we have the horsepower to pull the equipment that we do have for tillage. That's a concern right now, is that we might not have the horsepower we actually need for tillage, because I didn't check. Right, so let's just kind of make a bit of a mess here in terms of the line we're using, and just try and pick up all the stuff from kind of the tree line there. That tree starting off the line of trees down to the back of the field here, so we'll start off down at the very bottom and just kind of work our way very wonkily up the field. Not particularly keeping to any one line at any given time. It should mean that we get the field cleared up just that small bit quicker. I must admit though, for and not that new baler, this thing does push out quite nicely. I do have the nodders set up just the way that I want them. They are producing reasonably tight bales. I don't want to go over the top and have twine everywhere, so I haven't set it too tight there. As well as that, some of the innards are a bit rusty, so I mean, I don't want to chance my luck. I don't want to, over tighten the knotters and then find out that the plunger or the knives have decided to pack it in because the knots were too tight. Although, to be honest, the plunger would be the most likely to go. Did we drop a bale anywhere there? We should have. So I'm just going to make for this line here. I think we can get the baler onto it. I know I said we wouldn't keep to any one line, but when there's this much kind of lined up nicely like this, I mean, I'm not going to skip over it. We did drop a bale down over there. Well, earlier on we dropped a bale down over there. I don't know where the other bales, we dropped two apparently at this stage. Where that mystery bale actually is. It's coming up nicely though. I mean, we are getting probably 98% of the straw off the field. I'm just going to leave it in stubble until probably tomorrow, and cultivate the stubble in, and that'll chop it up nicely, give us a nice layer of chopped stubble, and bits of chopped straw, and what I will do with that is I will consult my little handbook that I have, because I'm not too used to chopping the straw, because of the, I think I'm not, I can't remember my story, I can't remember the storyline, oh no. I think I said that it was other farmers came in and baled the field with their own equipment, maybe? Am I retconning things again? Possibly, probably, perhaps. I should write things like that down, shouldn't I? But I will have to, in all seriousness, check with my little handbook of soil conditions to see what, if anything, leaving the chop stubble to rot will do. And it will be chop stubble. Out of character, I got a mod, the stubble cultivation mod, which works with chopped straw and literally any cultivator. It's a little script, and it makes it so that if you cultivate stubble with the script turned on, because it is one of those turn off and on again scripts, it's a toggleable script. If you have the script toggled on and you cultivate or stubble like this, you'll get a lovely chopped straw effect. And I believe the stubble goes away, so you just get chopped straw, no more stubble. Rather nice. Issue with that is, if you do that, you can't hire a worker on it afterwards. Which is fine with me, because I don't use hired workers, but just, it's a known issue with the mod. And is fully disclosed by the mod author, which, if there's an own issue and the mod author discloses it, you know, you guys know that I'm fine with that. This is actually really nice and relaxing. I mean, I know that it's a complete waste of time and fuel and probably money. In reality, because we're going to get something in the region of 65 euro a bale, I think it is. What is it? 43 euro a bale. 13% humidity though, so nice moisture content, nice low moisture content. Let's just continue onwards. Still down, is it? Yes. So we've just dropped a bale off the back there, and we are going to do this with the straw fields and the meadows. Now maybe next year I'll start working on getting a beef herd together. I think next year is probably going to be the time I start dropping money on that. Because what I'll need to get is probably a silage trailer of some description. I might get one that matches up with the trailer I already have. That is a Marshall QM11. I think they've got a sided variant of that. Unfortunately, it doesn't have a swap sides or quick swap mechanism, so I am going to need two trailers. And I'll probably get just to go, because I'll only be using grass silage with beef. What I'll do is I'll run through the meadow with a single chop forager, which I think the shop has one. It's called the, oh, it's a Russian brand. What's it called? The Care, I think. It's slightly modified from what I like to call the vanilla variant. You know, the variant you can go out in any shop in Eastern Europe in the probably mid-80s and get one. It has been slightly modified. There have been a few new parts put in. I mean, it's not selling for much, but they've kind of upgraded some of the parts to make them lighter, so it's a bit lighter than the default. And by that I mean outer character. I have gone into the i3D and changed the density, which you can do. If you want to do that, you go into Giant's Editor, you open up the i3D in Giant's Editor. You don't just go into Giant's Editor and say, hey, I want to do this. Now you open up the i3D in Giant's Editor and click on the section of the scene graph marked care. It'll be the first option, And what you do is you go into rigid body and change the density down. I have mine set at 0.13, which makes the mass of it just under 400, I think 400 kilos. Because I think the density is like one ton per meter cubed or something like that. It was set at 1, I moved the density down to 0.13. So I've made it significantly lighter, because I did some testing and it was just far too heavy. Now I will occasionally be editing mods like that, just making them the tiniest bit more user friendly. And kind of making them fit the way that I want them to fit the game. Maybe not the way the mod author envisioned them fitting, but the way that I kind of need or want them to fit. So that's kind of my mod editing. Be warned, it's going to happen. Kind of spiel. But I mean, anybody can edit a mod. I can personally say that anybody can edit a map, anybody can edit a mod. Yes, I know that not everybody can access GE, and I know I'm going slightly over time now, but deal with it. I'm just going to give a little spiel out of character and end the episode off there. Not everybody can access GE because maybe your laptop isn't powerful enough, maybe your computer's old, maybe you know there's an issue somewhere along the line that it won't work. Most of the edits I've done here on Coldborough, and I have given the map to a few people who I trust to not release it, because this is still private. I may have given it to people, but that is a trust thing. Most of the edits I've done don't require Giant's Editor. Throwing in Soil Mod does not require Giant's Editor, it just needs Notepad++. Changing the textures like I did, I don't know if I mentioned, but I did change some textures. The soil textures are now different, as are the grass textures. That also doesn't require Giant's Editor. Changing the textures of Soil Mod does not require Giant's Editor, because I got new textures there. And it's just, you know, the small things that you can do to add a bit of life to the map, because if you look at the grass now, it matches more with the bushes and trees. It just kind of brings the map a bit more to life, in my eyes at least. And, you know, it's literally a less than 2 minute edit. A 2 minute thing to change out texture files or to installing Soil Mod is a bit more complicated, I will give you guys that. But it's a 2 minute thing. And I always see that in the streams people say, oh no, I can't get Giant's Editor, I can't edit mods. I can't edit maps. Yes, you can. You can change textures. That's still an edit. It's not a groundbreaking edit, yes. It's not something that changes the look of... Well, it does change the look of the map, but it doesn't change the essence of the map. It doesn't... For example, here I've put in the Seedmaster. That kind of changes the map up a bit, because I can alter my playstyle to fit the Seedmaster. Which I think may be broken. I'm going to have to investigate there. Because that shouldn't have done that. That should not have made seeds yet. I think the script is... I think the script that runs the Seedmaster might have broken somehow. I'm going to have to check the log file when I'm done here. But that, you know, that's the kind of stuff that happens when you start editing mods and editing maps. But some of them are as simple as changing two lines in an XML. In any case, I've been Rainbow Dave. You've been watching Farming Simulator 15 on Coldborough Park Farm. Thank you all very much for watching. Until next time, stay safe and goodbye.